Hello, I'm Norbert Gleiche, MD, and I'm the medical director and the chief scientist at the Center for Human Reproduction here in New York City. It is my pleasure to talk to you today about the program that we here at CHR developed and also, frankly, patented. We have a patent for an algorithm that allows us to predetermine who is at risk for developing what is called premature ovarian aging, or some people call it also occult primary ovarian insufficiency. Now, why is all of this important? It is important for a whole variety of reasons, not the least being, if you go on the internet, there's suddenly an explosion of all kinds of companies that are offering you information about your fertility. And I think what's necessary is a word of warning. Our fertility is a very complex machinery. And I'm on purpose using that name because, like a very complex machinery, like, for example, a rocket going to the moon, our fertility is based on innumerable redundancies. In other words, we all wouldn't be alive, we all wouldn't be here if our successful fertility was dependent on just A causing B and B causing C. Because if that's how our fertility really worked, if A to B doesn't work right, has a fault, or if B to C doesn't work right, it would automatically mean that we are infertile. And since there are so many A to B's and B to C's, etc., etc., in the infertility process, there's so much involved, you can imagine that if any one of them was of such dominant importance that it could interrupt that whole chain of fertility proceeding successfully, again, we all wouldn't be here. So nature, like our engineers, when they're building a very complex machinery, nature has done exactly the same thing. It has created what is called redundancies. If A to B doesn't work, then there's a way to get from A to B through D, etc., etc. Now, this is only quite recently recognized, and this principle applies obviously not only to fertility, it's a general medical principle. I'm old enough to have been told in medical school that every gene in our body has only one function. Now, we know today that this is complete nonsense for exactly the same reason. In other words, biology, and with it fertility, is very, very complex. And therefore, to assume that you can do one blood test and that that blood test will tell you whether you're fertile or not is simply much too naive. And even two blood tests may not do it. Fertility really does not have a test. There's only one test to determine whether one of us is fertile, and that is sexual activity and trying to achieve a pregnancy. Now, obviously, that is not how most people who are interested in knowing what their fertility is will try to get an answer. But objectively and scientifically speaking, there really is no test besides trying that can guarantee you that you are fertile. And even trying to conceive gives you only, in most cases, a relative accurate answer, because the definition of fertility must be separated from the definition of sterility. Those are frequently interchangeably used words, but they are dramatically different. Because if either a female or either a male are sterile, that means that they have a medical problem or a problem that absolutely prevents them from achieving pregnancy with a partner. Infertility, on the other hand, doesn't mean that at all. Indeed, I'm telling new patients who come to us for a first infertility consultation that there's a reasonable possibility in many cases that while we are talking, they may already be pregnant and not know about it, because the definition of infertility in contrast to sterility is that the couple does not conceive within an expected time period. And that time period has been, by experts, really artificially, arbitrary in many ways, defined as 1 year. Within 1 year not conceiving, and if you are a relatively young couple, then you are declared to be infertile. If you're a little older, you should reach that conclusion actually a little quicker, not because that makes a lot of sense. Indeed, it takes older couples longer to conceive than younger couples, but it is generally felt that once you're above age 38, as a woman at least, you don't have that much time left, and therefore you shouldn't wait the whole year, and therefore there, the currently use definition of infertility, and when you start worrying and getting into testing, has been defined as 6 months. So infertility is complex, and infertility is relative. And doing just as is offered by most of these companies on the internet today, an AMH test or an FSH test or maybe both, is really far removed from telling you whether you're really fertile or not. And therefore be careful. Don't necessarily believe everything you're being told after undergoing these kind of home tests, because the information you may be getting back may be somewhat misleading or may be very misleading. And that misleading may go in both ways. You may be told you're fertile when you in reality have a very significant infertility problem that likely will prevent you from conceiving on your own. And on the other hand, you may be told that you're not fertile and suddenly you will discover that you're pregnant. So be careful with home testing and with many of those promises that are being made by many of these new companies. Now let me come back to the program I was speaking about at the beginning. What's My Fertility? The program for which we here at CHR received a U.S. patent, and the program that we here at CHR established as an internet program. Here the concept is quite different from all of those internet companies that want to tell you about your fertility. We are really trying to address a very different problem. And what we are trying to address with What's My Fertility is the fact that roughly 10% of all women, independent of race, ethnic background, what you eat, what you drink, what you do at work, and where you live, 10% of all women out there develop what is called premature ovarian aging or occult primary ovarian insufficiency. And like the term occult suggests, it's a quiet condition. It is not a condition that announces itself through symptoms. It happens quietly, and therefore women usually have absolutely no idea that they are amongst those 10% who prematurely age their ovary. What does it mean to prematurely age your ovaries? It means that at any given point, as a woman, you have fewer eggs left in your ovaries than the other 90% of your age-matched cohort. So you have fewer eggs left than you should. And for a certain while, it doesn't matter, because women have many more eggs than they will ever need in their lifetime. But usually somewhere around age 35, these women who have this problem fall below a certain threshold in the number of eggs in their ovaries. And once they fall below that threshold, suddenly they have problems conceiving. In other words, at age 32 or 30, these women still have perfectly fine fertility. And therefore, this diagnosis of premature ovarian aging or occult primary ovarian insufficiency basically almost didn't exist 50 years ago, because women had their children so much earlier. And if by age 35 they suddenly no longer felt pregnant, they were usually happy. Nowadays, when many women just start thinking about having children at age 35, or at age 19 start taking hormonal contraceptives, and suddenly at age 35 or 36 come off and expect to get pregnant, boom, there's that big surprise: I'm not getting pregnant. And that is today a major problem in infertility, because by that point, those women no longer can get pregnant on their own. They need us, they need fertility clinics to get pregnant. And if they are particularly unlucky, their premature ovarian aging may be so far advanced that even IVF with their own eggs is no longer possible, and they may need donor eggs. And this is the problem that we are trying to tackle with What's My Fertility. Again, it involves 10% of all women out there, but in fertility centers, the percentage of women affected by this diagnosis is obviously even much larger. So this is a major problem in infertility. And the concept of What's My Fertility is to find a way to help women not to discover that they suffer from premature ovarian aging only after age 35, whenever they start trying to get pregnant for the first time, but maybe earlier, in their late teens, in their early 20s, because it changes all of their options. Think about it for a moment. Let's assume a 21-year-old understands that she may be at an increased risk for premature ovarian aging. She can go on a follow-up program where, let's say, once a year, once every 2 years, she gets checked with a very limited number of tests. And in those cases, if she indeed turns out to develop premature ovarian aging, we will not diagnose her only in her late 30s, where she definitely will need IVF or maybe even donor eggs, but we will be able already at age 25 or 27 to say to her, hey, you just started to come off the curve. You are just starting to show distinct signs of premature ovarian aging, when she still has a good number of years to be above that threshold that prevents her from getting pregnant. In other words, she then has options, which she later in life doesn't have. If you're diagnosed first time at age 37, 38, IVF is your only option, if you're lucky. But if you're diagnosed at age 27, then suddenly you can say, maybe my career is not that important after all as a priority, and I'm going to have kids first and career later. Or, and those of you who have been listening to our videos here at CHR, we are by no means a center that pushes a lot of egg freezing, but if you're diagnosed at age 25 or 27, as a woman who is prematurely aging your ovaries, if there is a group of women who really would benefit from egg freezing, that is these women. And that's what's My Fertility is all about, and why What's My Fertility is really so different from basically all those programs that are currently being offered on the internet that are trying to tell you something, whatever that may be, about your alleged fertility levels. I hope that this has given you some new ideas about what you should and shouldn't do in considering your fertility. If you're a young woman out there, think about trying this program. We are offering the screening for free on our website. And if you are a parent, think about your daughter. If you're a grandparent, think about your granddaughter. Thanks very much for listening. Bye-bye.